All right, so first thing you're gonna wanna do is you're gonna wanna grab your four mounting pins. You're gonna insert them on your back plate. You're gonna insert them through the side that says Intel, so that when you lay it down, the side that has AMD printed on it is facing up. And you're gonna repeat this four times. All right, so right here, we're gonna be breaking the plastic pieces off of the molding for rows both A and B. All right, so here we're just gonna put the backplate on the motherboard and we're gonna lay it down flat. All right, so we're gonna take these plastic spacers marked A and we're gonna put those on each post surrounding your CPU socket. And here we're just going to install this metal bracket as shown. Next, we're gonna take these plastic pieces, part B, and we're just gonna screw those on top of the bracket. Just finger tight is fine. You don't need to over tighten them. Here we're just going to apply some thermal paste. You don't want to apply too much. Very important step here. We're going to take this plastic film off of your tower cooler. So now we're going to install the tower cooler. We're gonna put the mounting bracket across the top of it and we're gonna tighten these screws down. You're gonna apply some pressure, but you're not gonna over tighten it. You wanna make sure you have firm mounting pressure, but again, you don't wanna add too much torque. Now we're going to install the plastic mounting kits onto the fans. And you'll want to make sure that you have the plastic mounting brackets attached on the front of one fan, on the back of the other, in order to make sure that the air is flowing the same direction when they're attached to your cooler. Now you'll want to take your 4-pin PWM splitter and just attach that to your motherboard. Now you're going to want to attach your fans. You're going to want to make sure that they are both have their airflow going in the same direction. You don't want to have them so that they're just both pulling air from the tower cooler. And last but not least, you're going to attach each fan to the 4-pin PWM splitter. So after this, your tower cooler should be all set and ready to get going. Make sure you subscribe and like our channel if possible, please. We appreciate the support. If you have any questions or comments, go ahead and leave them below.